Hello and welcome to the third guide. Today I'm talking about air micro. I just explained the basics. I will do a few other guides later with some advanced strategies, but yeah, today just the basics. I don't want to talk about the build order as well because this is another guide and I don't want to give too many informations at once. So all in all, I can say to the build I'm doing quite early air because I start without any research station. I would highly recommend to beginners like you to build one research station and two air factories in the early game, because the research stations can help you to get air upgrades a lot of faster, and you don't get that many research points if you don't destroy units in the early game, so you really need one research station. But if you have quite a good air micro, and if it's possible to kill a lot of units in the early game, the research station is needed because you get your research points from destroying the units. In this game I saw that my opponent is even doing earlier air than I did. I was quite irritated by that, because I think his factories couldn't run the whole time. I think he had to pause them at one point of time to expand, or he expanded slowlier than I did. So let's go to the first air fight. So here he was sniping the engineer from my teammate. That's a really good choice, because the engineer can for example heal the mess point, and he can build an AA tower for example. So the best thing is if he's targeting the engineer as well. You can see that I press A on the ground a few times. I make this so the fighters search a new target, just like here, just A on the ground. Especially if your air is standing still, it's really important. And I researched the training, or you can research two trainings as well in an early air fight like this, if only up to maybe 12 bombers or fighters are fighting against each other. And the early air fight is normally more helpful than faster shields. Okay, now I show you something else. After you make a bombing run on a building, press S and give a new move order so your air won't mess up its formation and flying too long over AA towers. When I harass someone, I kill, like I already mentioned, first the engineer, because he can't rebuild the buildings now fast from orange. He can't build an AA tower, that's really helpful. Another thing, I make a little mistake at this point soon, is you really need, if you play air, a good map awareness. You need a radar at the front as well, because if someone wants to bomb something, your enemy, you have to see it early, so you can react to this. And if someone is bombing a building and you attack his air, your fighters are behind his fighters and you normally win air, even if you have less air than he has. So a radar is really important for playing air. If you have an air advantage like I had in this game, it's really important that you try to harass the enemy's air player so he can't If you snipe a few mass points, you can't catch up. And you can take your advantage into the mid and, in this case, into the late game. As well, it gives you a few research points. So I just decided to snipe a few mass points for my opponent, but there is a little danger. But I just hope my opponent doesn't get it, because in this case, if I attack him in his base, he could just try to snipe a ACU of us. And in this case, we might have lost the game just because of this mistake. Because the game mode is like normal assassination. So you always have to think about this as well. If you're behind and if your enemy is attacking you with air and you still have a few fighters, you can try to snipe the enemy, because his air is far away from the ACUs probably, and that's maybe a good chance to win a lost game. Now we are in the late game. Another really important thing as air player is to protect your teammate, or especially his land. Now I make some A clicks on the ground again that my fighters keep firing. And because of the enemy's adapters, I move my air back. And yeah, my teammate have a few adapters as well. And I wanted to force the land back. That's why I attacked his SU, and now I made a little mistake. I thought I can snipe it, but now my air is turning around stupid, and I lost too many fighters till I best S and give a new move order so they don't fly too long over the AA. But still, the adapters did a good job and destroyed a lot of fighters. That's why normally, exactly after the bombs are dropped, you normally press S on the keyboard and move your air back with a new move order. So now I just protect the land again. The land, especially he has jump jets, and if my air's there, it can attack the enemy units when they jump jet. And now I saw he's moving his land back again from the away again from the ACU, and now I'm just going to snipe him. I hope the video helped you a little bit, the guide. And on greater maps or bigger maps, it's important to build one or two research stations. And yeah, thank you for watching and have a nice week.